Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with our mobile computing subject. The next topic in the subject is a Bluetooth technology. So actually there is no need to say about the Bluetooth technology because nowadays everyone is familiar about this Bluetooth. Okay, so let's see what is the standards that we used in this technology and what is the range and what are the different aspects that are considered develop this Bluetooth technology. Okay, so let's see the introduction part of this Bluetooth. It is a wireless technology based on mobile computing technology. So we know that Bluetooth is a wireless technology which is based on a mobile computing technology. Being an open wireless technology standard, it is used to send or receive data to connected devices. Okay, so because it is an open wireless technology standard, what the use of Bluetooth technology? Just to send and receive the data which are connected devices. The thing here is the devices that are connected, for those devices only we can send the data and we can receive the data. So without the connections, you can't send and you can't take the data from the unconnected devices. So it is also known as IEEE 802.15 standard. So just remember this number. So whenever they are just given IEEE 802.15 standard. So don't confused. 802.15 is nothing but a Bluetooth. Is another name for Bluetooth is IEEE 802.15. The data can send or receive at a certain distance, that is used a band of 2.4 to 2.485 gigahertz. Actually, the Bluetooth technology, if you take the wireless or Wi-Fi, whatever the technology, it can be ranged, some distance will be there. So based on the bandwidth that is provided by that wireless communication. But here the Bluetooth can send or receive the data only to the certain distance, it is not supported for the long distance. And it uses a band of 2.4 to 2.485 gigahertz. The developing unit of this technology, we are saying it is a developing unit. Why we are saying it is a developing unit? It is not the developed one. Still, some more, every year some more modifications are adding to this Bluetooth technology. And it is increasing the distance. Okay. So, actually, why it is a developing unit means we are not satisfied to the certain distance. We want to be extend the distance of the Bluetooth, because the Bluetooth technology is a very useful technology and it is very simple to implement it. So it's better to make it as more convenient to everyone. So that's why the developing unit of this technology is a group of 5 companies. The 5 companies are developing this Bluetooth technology. That group, you call it as a special interest group. A special interest group which was formed in 1998. The companies that are formed this special interest group are Ericsson, Intel, IBM, Nokia and Toshiba. So these 5 companies called special interest group is formed. And these people are working on this Bluetooth technology. The range of Bluetooth technologies over which data can be exchanged is less than 10 meters. Actually, it is the data that can be sent or received is less than 10 meters. But the latest version of Bluetooth 5.0 can exchange data in the range of 40 to 400 meters. So they are still working on that to make this distance to increase. So previously it is only 10 meters, but now the 5.0 version can exchange the information up to 40 to 400 meters. The speed at which data transmission occurs is around 1 megabits per second. So the speed is also more. It's just 1 megabits per second. The data is transmitting from source to the destination. Okay. So now let's see the applications where this Bluetooth technology will be used. The applications are Bluetooth speakers are there, Bluetooth headphones, Bluetooth headset, which are used for the calling purpose, not the data transferring. So, okay, it's just a calling purpose, headsets. Wireless mouse and keyboards. So, nowadays, everyone is using the wireless mouse and keyboards and the Bluetooth gaming consoles. And still so many are there. So, these are the main applications of the Bluetooth technology. And now let's see the advantage. Before going to know see the architecture, let's see what are the advantages and disadvantages in this Bluetooth technology. So if you know this, then we will see this architecture. The advantages of using the Bluetooth technology is it is a wireless technology. So there is no infrastructure is needed, means the wired cables are not needed because it is a wireless technology. Very simple to form a piconet. So the piconet that I'll explain in the architecture. So piconet is nothing but is a combination of the nodes. A master and slave communications will be there. So that is a piconet. A very simple to form a piconet, cheap technology, robust and low energy consumption. So these are the advantages of using the Bluetooth technology. Now let's see the disadvantages. The disadvantages of Bluetooth technology is low in bandwidth because it only transfer the data if it is previous version, it's only 10 meters. But in 5.0 version, 40 to 400 meters only, and the bandwidth is low. The data transmission range is a constraint as it is very less. So these are the advantages and disadvantages. So this about the introduction part of the Bluetooth technology. In the next video, I'll explain about the architecture of Bluetooth technology. Thank you.